So, one of the new things for you guys that previous year 12 groups haven't had to do is bond enthalpies or bond energies. And there's just a couple of things that you need to know first of all. A bond enthalpy is the amount of energy required to break one mole of a particular bond, right? So to break it. And the thing that I always sort of keeps a little catchphrase to remember it is breaking up is always hard to do. So it requires a lot of energy. So it's endothermic to break a bond. So these values will always be positive. Just like it's really easy to get together with someone, so making a bond with someone is actually quite easy. And often it, you know, it's quite hot and steamy, so it releases a lot of energy. So, endothermic, because it's hard to break up. Exothermic, because when you get together, it's all hot and steamy. Nice way to remember it. When you use the values you're given, don't worry about changing the sign to negative for it being broken. There's a way we do it that allows for that already. So just use the positive values, the bond enthalpies, when we're doing the calculations. Don't worry about flipping the sign on them. Okay, and you'll see why that happens. The example I'm going to give you is I'm going to go through a question from the 2010 Level 3 paper. Now, as I was saying to you before, this content has been shifted down to Level 2. So if you're looking for past achievement standard work on this, so you can try and practice it, it is in Achievement Standard 90780. Okay, so you'll find examples for that in Achievement Standard 90780. Don't worry about the other questions in that, because that is Level 3 stuff that you're not expected to do. But there are good bond enthalpy questions in this standard that you can find on the NZQA website. Okay, so let's go through the example from the 2010 paper and see how we go with it. I'm not going to worry about states of matter, but technically this should all be done in the gas phase. So what we're going to start with is we're going to have ethanol. So CH3CH2OH. We're going to react that with oxygen, and it gives us the balanced equation, so it gives us these three O2s required. Now, automatically, we know this is combustion. We should expect combustion to be exothermic. If our final answer is positive, we've made a mistake. So get that in your mind straight away. This is combustion, burning. So we do it to create heat energy, so it's got to be exothermic. Alright, we're going to have our two carbon dioxides made, and our, very quickly done the maths, hopefully get it right, got six of them, three H2Os, that doesn't look right, so I've got something wrong there. There's one of them missing. Okay, cool. Rightio. So, for this reaction to be activated, a certain amount of energy needs to be provided. That energy is to break enough bonds and to cause enough collisions to occur in the correct orientation. And we're not asking you to explain all of that stuff. What we want to know is, what's the answer? How much energy? Well, you get given a whole list of data. The first thing we have to do, though, is work out which bonds are actually being broken. Well, the best thing to start with is to draw these things out. And I'm a bit tedious with it. I draw out every single one. So it says three oxygens. I'm going to draw three oxygens. And sometimes you'll see it's like 1.5, 3/2. So all I draw there is, if I had, say, 3/2, so 1.5, I draw a complete one, and then I draw one, and then just put a bracket around it and times 1/2. Okay, you'll see why that's important in a minute. Okay, so here I've got CH3CH2OH, so here you're probably seeing why Lewis structures and organic chemistry and all that stuff is becoming so important. We need to draw these things out. We've got oxygen, and it's a double bond, we should know from doing our Lewis structures, and there are three of them, so I'm going to draw all three of them. I'm making two carbon dioxides. Again, I remember my Lewis structure. I'm not going to worry about the lone pairs, but I need to show two carbon dioxides, and I've got three waters, so I'll draw those. Okay. So those are the bonds being made, those are the bonds being broken. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the sum of all the bonds being broken here, so I'm going to add them all up, and then I'm going to add up all of these, and I'll have two numbers down the bottom, just like an accounting spreadsheet. Then I'm going to go that number minus that number, and that will give me my answer. It's that simple. So we're going to go through it. How many CH bonds do I have to break to make those? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm going to find the data for that, and I'm going to go 5 times, and it tells me that this is 412 kilojoules per mole. 412. I've got to break a CC bond in there. So I'm not finished with this molecule yet. And there's one of those. So again, just to be a little tedious, I like to do it this way. I actually write the 1 times. And a carbon-carbon single bond is 348 kilojoules per mole. Now, you can see there's an OH bond there and there's an OH bond there. I'm going to ignore that for now. I could actually leave that together, but I'm not going to. I find it easier to break everything and then make everything. So I've got a CO bond to break and an OH bond to break there. So my CO bond is 360. Okay. I'm sorry, I've adapted this question a little bit. It doesn't actually have the OH bond there. So excuse me for one moment. Apologies here. OH bond is 463. Okay. But for it to react, we also have to get through all of these. So I've got 3 times my oxygen-oxygen double bond, which is 496. Okay, so if I can get someone to do that bit of maths for me, please, we'll get a number that goes at the bottom.
4719.
4719? Excellent. Okay, now let's see what's being made. We've made some CO double bonds. 1, 2, 3, 4 of those. Again, we've got some data that's given to us, but that is 743. Notice that it's a lot higher than what the CO single bond was. So double bond takes a lot more energy to break or releases a lot more energy when it's made than a single bond does. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 OH bonds, and we said that was 496. So again, I just need someone to do that for the maths for me, please.
5,948.
And then all I have to do now is go the first number minus the second number, so that's allowing for this being exothermic. So that minus that equals, I'm hoping it's going to be somewhere around negative 1400.
Negative
1229. Okay, negative 1229. It's a little different to what the value in the book is, but that's okay. That might be because I used a different value for the OH bond. Sorry, negative 1,229 kilojoules per mole. Okay. Now, if there are some mathematical errors in there, it's not important. It's the process. Balanced equation. Draw out everything so you can see every chemical bond that is involved. Do it like a tally sheet, adding them all up, and then find your answer there. All right. You can see that. I see where my mistake's come in, I think. That was meant to be a 1, wasn't it?
No.
Oh, no, that was for them. Ah, there's my mistake. It's a mathematical error. It is a mathematical error. That number there should be 463. So I'm sorry I made an error there. So we will get the right number. do that one again for me. Apologies there.
Yeah, so that's 5,750.
4 times 743 and 6 times...
Yeah,
so sorry, 5,750. Yeah. Okay.
That
works. Yeah, that's right. We'll get what it is.
That's
1,031. Sorry?
1,031.
Okay, might have actually been, I just misread it out by a factor of 10 here. Okay, as I say, the actual numbers aren't important, it's the process. So, draw everything out, identify the bonds that need to be broken, then identify the bonds that need to be made, and if we lay it out that way, it makes it really easy to look at in an exam question. Okay, for you to see that you've done everything, and for a marker to see that you've got the right process, at least. Okay? And that's our last thing that we need to learn about in the energy reactions things.